A very good afternoon to all the students of UC second year Arts, Science and Commerce. I am Muhammad Ghulam Rabbani from Department of English, working at Nehru Arts, Science and Commerce College, Kanthikiri, Hubli. Dear students, without taking much time, I would like to deal with job application. So in your previous class, I taught you people in detail, given the format and style of letter writing. And the format of letter writing is that first heading comes, then salutation, body of the letter, and then subscription, that is the concluding part of the letter. For format of the letter, 2 marks will be awarded, and for body of the letter, 3 marks will be awarded. If you write only the format, not the body of the letter, then you won't be awarded even a single mark, you'll be awarded 0. So be careful while you are writing. You have to write the format as well as body of the letter. So for job application letter, there are 2 ways of job application letter, or 2 formats also we can say. In one, you have to highlight your educational qualification in the body of the letter. In another is covering letter and resume writing you have to write separately. So here, in your previous class, I taught you people job application letter, and the education was highlighted in the body of the letter. But here, it can be divided into 2. One is covering letter, another is a biodata or resume or curriculum vitae will be mentioned separately. So without much time, let me start here. First, you have to, when you get the question, you have to read carefully, because the name and address of the receiver you will find here, and reference you will find. So you have to, and the post also will be mentioned here. For example, the question is, the following advertisement appeared in the New Indian Express, name of the newspaper, on 3rd February 2014. According to your course text, what is called workbook, it is mentioned. Write a letter of application in response to it. And to whom? Global Finance and Investment Limited. And requires, that is junior assistant, what would be the qualification? The qualification is second PUC with the knowledge of computer, Kannada and English, then essential experienced preferred, then to whom you are going to apply, it is mentioned here, apply within a week to the manager, Global Finance and Investment Limited, KC Road, Gadag, 58210101. Now you have to write the letter. How you are going to write? First, everything should be written at the left hand side only. This is American style of letter writing, and nowadays it is prescribed, and you have to follow this system of letter writing. Earlier you used to write from, then date, then to, but now it is not needed. Simply you have to write your name and your address in place of from, and then date, then in place of to, you have to write simply the name of the receiver and address. So if you write from, it will be okay, but you should not write comma. If you write to, it will be okay, but you should not write comma. Without comma, you can write. For example, here, below that, it is not space here, that's why I have not written, but you will find the instruction. In instruction, it will be mentioned that XXX for your name and YY is for your address. For example, here XXXYYY. XXX is a name of a sender. YYY is the name of the address. Then leave a space and then write. You can write dated also, or simply you can mention date. What is called in question? The advertisement was given on 3rd February 2014. So after 1 day or 2 days, you have to write. So here 4th February 2014. Then again space and write name and address of the receiver. To whom you have to write? You have to write to the manager. Here it is mentioned. So the manager, Global Finance and Investment Limited, KC Road, Gadag, 582101. Next, you have to write salutation that respected sir, bar or madam, put a comma. Or this salutation you can write after subject also, or before subject, both are acceptable. Now the subject is application for the post of a junior assistant. Already it is mentioned here. What is called? Requires junior assistant. So what? It will be the same. Application for the post of junior assistant. If the question is asked for a post of lecturer in English, then you have to write application for the post of lecturer in English. But is it? It is mentioned here. What is called? Application for the post of junior assistant. So you have to write. Then reference you have to give. Your advertisement in the New Indian Express dated 3rd February 2014. So you have to give the reference. Reference is already here. And you have to give the reference. The New Indian Express on 3rd February 2014. Then you have to start the body of the letter. When you start the body of the letter, you make paragraph, and from paragraph you have to start. In response to your advertisement mentioned above, you can say that in response to your advertisement stated above or mentioned above, I am applying for the post of junior assistant. Or if you want to make it simply, if you want to simplify it, you can write I am applying or I would like to apply for the said post. So the said post would be, that is called junior assistant. Full point. I am fluent in both Kannada and English, and I have computer knowledge too. I have an experience of 2 years as a junior assistant. So I have an experience of 2 years as a junior assistant, or you can say I have worked as junior assistant for 2 years. If I am given an opportunity, I will discharge my duties to the best of your satisfaction. So you can write, if I am given the post or opportunity, I will discharge my duties to the best of your satisfaction. I have also enclosed a resume and I hope it will meet your requirement. I have also enclosed resume, or you can say biodata or curriculum vitae. I hope that it will meet your requirement. Below that you have to write, leave a margin or gap and write thank you, then full point. Below that again there would be a space. There is no space, that's why I have written here only. Yours faithfully, comma you have to put, or you have to write yours sincerely. Then again space and write your name XXX, and in bracket you have to write signature, because for XXX you cannot write signature. So in bracket you can write SIGNATURE, signature, so that the examiner will be very much pleased and he will come to know that signature is needed above the name of the sender, and he will give marks. Next, you have to highlight, that is called resume, or you can mention biodata, or you can write curriculum vitae too. So what would be the format? The format is like name, you have to write name XXX, father's name you can write ABC, or any name you can mention, any name you can mention, and date of birth or age. For example, if you want to mention age, you can write 30 years or 28 years, or if you want to mention date of birth, you can mention, for example, 10th March, 1990. Then permanent address you have to write, then nationality like Indian, the knowledge of languages you have to highlight, for example, Canada, English, Hindi, etc. Then you have to highlight educational qualification. You have to highlight your educational qualification by making columns like name of the examination, then board or university, then year or marks, then subject. For example, here, number one, SSLC. Then you have to write board, name of the board. Then how much marks did you obtain, you have to write here. And then the subject. Then PUC you have to highlight. Then if degree, but here it is needed only PUC. If degree, then degree you have to highlight. Then experience, you have to write your experience. For example, I have worked as junior assistant for 2 years, or I have 2 years of experience working as junior assistant. Then other interest or hobbies, you have to mention your hobbies. For example, I am interested in sports, or in creating poetry, or you can say my hobbies are creating poetry, collecting information, playing games or sports. Then write place, you have to mention the place, for example, Hubli, then date. This is the format of resume writing. So if you write like this, then you will be awarded 5 marks. In your previous class, last class, your educational qualification is highlighted here in the body of the letter. But here it is the second format of a job application letter, that is, it is covering letter, and that is for what is called resume. It is divided into 2 parts. So you go through that, and notes will be sent to you people. You note down, write on your fair notebook for your further reference, and if you will have doubt, you can clarify your doubts by asking questions. So let me stop for the day. I will continue to the next class.